So obviously you're saying, obviously you're Muslim, yeah?
Yeah, yeah, mashallah.
Okay, so obviously, you know, you use seasoning, which I appreciate.
What do you mean?
So, you know, you season your food. What do you mean you season your food? You wouldn't be mad at you season your food, innit? Like, you know what I'm saying? You're eating, why are you even busting up?
Wait. I'm just trying to work out my brain how it went from, yeah, you're Muslim, to, yeah, you season your food. Like, what the fuck does my religion have to do with what I do to my food, bro? I'm so confused right now, bro. Okay, but well, why did you start the sentence with, yeah, you're Muslim? I don't know.
Okay, for example, right? I know you season your food, yeah?
Where are you going with this?
But I don't know if he seasons his food.
Okay.
I'm still waiting
for you to tie back to be Muslim, bro.
Because obviously, you know, that part of the world, you know, that's where some of the best seasoning comes
from. Yeah, but I'm not from that part of the world, though.
Yeah, but like it comes in with the culture, it's with like, the heritage.
It's like seasoning comes from Mecca, bro. It doesn't work like that.
It does come from Mecca. Yeah, but
I'm not from there, though.
Yeah.
I'm Nigerian.
Yeah, Niger, innit? Yeah.
Well, to what the Niger don't season?
Obviously.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
But you were talking about Mecca and that side of the world, bro. I'll be honest, you're all over the place.
He's cool, you know what I mean, though, man.
You fucked yourself.
The thing is, I still vote for the audience.
Does anyone? No, I'll be honest. I actually have no clue what you're talking about. Like, I don't know what you mean. Like, I don't know.
Welcome back to Late Night London. I'm just Chris. I'm with Wild G, Mr. Ennis, and we've got Billy the Goat in the building.
Myself Billy, aka M1 Billy, aka Starboy Billy, Billy Billions, Bill Gates, Bob the Builder, Billy Allen. You get me, man? I'm dead.
Gangsta. All the names.
Christ. All the bills. So, where was we?
I don't know if we can go into that.
Yeah,
we can fully go into it.
We can. What was you saying? What was you going to say?
Because, Nana, don't say what was I saying. It was you. It's what were you saying?
I tried.
What was the reason you was on?
He said, yeah, he's got a porn podcast, isn't it?
No. My friends have a porn podcast. It's not a porn podcast. It's not even a porn. Like, it's a podcast, basically. It's called 21st Century Sex.
It's a podcast,
it's called 21st Century Sex. So check it out on YouTube. It's basically a couple, mixed race couple, CC and Rio, and they interview like OnlyFans stars, porn stars, like dominatrix, like basically anything sex related. They're kind of just uncovering these topics and like bringing them to life because we all do it and all talk about it.
Who's we?
I don't know what you're talking about.
We.
Exactly. Who's we?
My boy, Billy, get him.
Bro, if you want to we, the toilet's there, bro. It's not we, bro.
No, but basically we had a girl on the other day and it got a bit mad, innit? And I obviously should know that it's a porn star. So if I say things like, have you ever been naked on the podcast? She's probably going to get naked, innit? So half that podcast didn't even make it on YouTube because obviously.
Send it to me.
Send it to you, yeah. I'd have to do OnlyFans for the podcast. Just so people can watch the podcast.
Patreon.
Make more money off that, bro.
Yeah. So it was a madness. And she was talking about things like CNC.
Yeah.
Which is consent, not consent.
That's brave.
When I asked her what her favorite fetish is, she said, I like the idea of being raped, but not being raped. So it was a bit of a mad
case.
Because this is mad, yeah? Because I see a video today of R. Kelly singing in prison.
Oh, yeah. I didn't watch it.
And that weren't rape, not rape, but then he didn't go to prison, not prison.
Yeah. But basically, she had a good thing. She likes the idea of a guy just fully dominating her, basically, is what she was saying. But she said she ain't found a guy to do that yet.
But I'm saying that, like, you know, like, she's based here undercover police, bro. Because she's looking for rapists, bro.
True.
She's looking for rapists, bro.
She's deep undercover, bro. That's the devil.
Any guy that agrees to raping you is a rapist, bro.
No, he's not raping you. It's the idea.
If a girl says to any of us here, bro, I want you to do the CNC thing, we'll all say no. Like,
I'm not on it.
Exactly. Why? Because it's weird. It's rapey, bro. Even if it's not rape, it's still rape, bro. Because she's asking you to make her feel like she's being raped.
Yeah.
So regardless,
and you have to realize the guy has to fantasize about, like, he has to like
agree that that's a fantasy. That's wild. All right, how do you throw that? That's wild.
That's what I'm saying. But you have to agree to be a rapist, bro.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm just going to punch you up and rape you, but I'm not going to punch you up and rape you.
And that's the point I'm making, bro. If you can agree to be a rapist, then you're a rapist, bro.
I agree.
I don't give a shit, bro.
So anyway, so that clip didn't go over well on TikTok, just put it that way. So that got taken down.
No, bro, that's what I was saying to you, because you were talking about that you asked her to get naked, she got naked.
No, I said to her, have you ever been, like, because she's that's OnlyFans, isn't it?
Yeah.
And she was describing some of the scenes that she's done, which I was like, what the fuck? Like, okay. I was like, what's the craziest scene you did? She was like, oh, the other day I had like two dicks in my ass. And I was like,
what, wait, at the same time?
Yeah.
How does that work?
That was my question. So, and then I was like,
two arseholes or something?
No, just, she just.
Just widened up the arsehole.
No,
but then don't that make the man them gay?
I was going to say that. You got to question the man them, bro. Because that means the meats are touching, bro.
No, I've always said that. When I've heard that man them run a train and one was like, yeah, one was in this hole, one was in that hole. I'm like, whoa, bro, you're basically rubbing on each other while you're in two different holes.
Bro, you're not even deep in it. They're not in two different holes, bro. They're both putting it in the same at the same time. Means the meats are touching, bro. That means the Siamese meats, bro.
That's like using the same cubicle in the toilet. Do you know what I mean? This doesn't make no sense.
They're rubbing their
fridge. I heard about this sword fight touching, bro.
That means they're helping each other put it in, bro. Like, they're helping each other. Like, yo, you put it in and put it there.
Yeah,
like,
I'll hold that hole while... Oh, you know,
that means the hole, they probably held each other's meats.
Yeah,
I'll be honest. They probably did. Bro.
The show was mad. I don't know why. I don't know why I thought it would go any way different. Because their whole lives are madness. Their normal, our threshold of what's normal is their everyday. Because I literally, when we left the show, I was like, "Oh, what you got planned for the rest of the day?" She's like, "I'm about to go do a gangbang with five black guys." Just cash. Like she was saying, she's getting shot. Like, I was like, "That's just that's your evening." Anyways,
but she was alienating you when she said that, though.
But I want to know, like,
she made it on purpose. Yeah. She's like, black guys.
Like, on purpose, yeah.
Black guys.
She said a couple of letters.
Black guys.
But I want to know, like, what has to go wrong in your life for you to end up like that, bro?
Well, she said, I'm fucking saying the whole episode now. She's saying that she was pregnant. She had a kid.
Okay.
And the husband left her to all the money, to all the assets, took everything and just ducked out.
So she just sold her pussy.
Basically.
That's not an excuse, I'll be honest.
Oh, I think at the time she was there's a progression. First she got into being a pole dancer. Mm. And then someone saw her pole dancing, was like, hey, would you do X? Which then she did OnlyFans. And then OnlyFans, someone went, hey, I saw your OnlyFans, do you want to do porn? So like, it's a slow, like.
Yeah, graduated, yeah. Because some of them go from cam girls, innit? Back in the day, they used cam girls.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
And now they move on to.
What's a cam girl? I'm
you know, a babe station. You know, XTV when you had Sky.
But you lot know Adam 22, innit?
Yeah. They've just gone and they're making so much money on there.
He does a podcast, bro. And I'm telling you, bro, they just get straight to the clouting, bro.
With his missus.
I'm not saying I watch it, but this is what he's saying, innit?
No, he says they have an OnlyFans account where they do the podcast, they bring a girl on, and then they smash.
That's the point I'm making. I'm saying that's how you do it, bro. I'm not condoning it, but I'm saying if you are going to get into the podcast industry, bro, do it wholeheartedly, bro. Don't just tell them to strip and then leave it there.
Just Chris.
I'm saying you got to finish the job.
I'm married, man.
So basically, Chris's retirement plan is to basically clock the missus on podcast just finish.
Would you do that?
Then just finish, done.
On OnlyFans.
I already make good money, man.
10 M's a year.
I can make that.
You can.
I can make that.
But no, but I'm just saying.
I don't sound arrogant.
Bluetooth.
Yeah, you did Bluetooth with money as well. I thought that was an East London thing.
I copied it from East London. So.
what I'm saying is, you earn that money, that's fine. But I'm saying retirement plan. I'm saying the get out.
No.
You start crossing stuff off like Will Smith. Do you know what I mean? Jumping from air balloons and all that.
No. I think that, like, as you said, there's got to be something drastically, I don't even know what drastically could go wrong to make me do the level to do that.
We're saying people go wrong, yeah, but some people don't.
Some people choose to do this. And I have nothing against it. She's made a great life for her kids. Yeah. She loves her job.
I have something against it, by the way. I have to let you know that. Anyways. sorry, I just had to let her know that you're an idiot. That's not an excuse. Your husband leaving you is not an excuse, bro. Just bare.
But she enjoys it though.
I get that, but they want
to
feel.
That's what I'm saying. That's why it's not an excuse. She just wanted a reason to do it. She used that as a reason, but it's not really a reason, bro. She just wanted to do it.
True.
No one knows about her.
No, but sometimes with them kind of stories, they want to feel desirable after, innit? Their man's left them. They want to feel desirable. They start doing something where people are watching them, doing stuff for them, all that kind of stuff, and then.
The thing that surprised me, actually, I shouldn't have been surprised, is how thirsty people were for the content. like the fact that we launched the podcast and it got like millions, it's on like 6-7 million total views within like a week. I was like, people are thirsty.
On what, TikTok?
Yeah, thirsty for content.
That's,
like,
no, that's that, bro. Literally, that's easy, it's just nowadays.
Like, because the clip that went viral was one day, the host, I'm not on the show, I'm like behind the scenes, by the way. I'd asked these for Offset. So I'm Offset, and I was just like, yo, like, throw it in. And, you know, just because I was, just wanted to throw the question into the mix. And the main thing that went viral was where she was like, the girls were interested in asking her, how do you squirt, basically. And she went through a tutorial.
See, this is my kind of content.
She went through.
he's like, now we're talking my language.
This is what I want to listen to you.
So she went through a whole tutorial, bruv. Like, how you do it. And that's the one that got 2.7 million. Like, and people in the comments are like taking notes, bruv. Like, people are like, oh, I've been trying so hard with my missus. I'm going to go home here and try that. The women are all commenting.
They're talking about the pressure.
Yeah,
I may have come across it.
Oh, you see?
In more ways than one.
Bro, you bookmarked it, bro. Not like you bookmarked it, bro. Nah, you had your favorites, bro.
Do you know the mad thing, yeah? So, Rira, what I was saying is, he's the host. Like, he went to work, yeah? And his boss came up to him and was like, is this you? It already had reached, like, talk about the viral effect. He's already reached his bosses and that, and his company.
Remember someone snitch.
And
so what, did he get fired?
No, they were cool with it.
What?
They were like,
because they're freaks. If he's a big money company, they're freaks, bro.
They were cool.
They're about to ask him bare contacts. You got the, that one.
Like,
that
how one. Can I apply to be involved?
Yeah. Because if his bosses are asking him questions, they're the Dubai guys, isn't it?
I think the crazy thing is, like, I'm not even trying to. Some Epstein Island,
Bro, your man got that money.
But I was going to ask you, though, what are you on if your missus says she wants to do it?
What's to do what exactly though?
Yeah, exactly. That's you got.
What's to do what, like
the Adam 22 thing?
Nah,
been on it.
That's his thing, innit? Like, no one was you surprised when they did that? I wasn't. It's like there was their relationship. Because even before they launched that, I watched his show as well, innit? Even before that, he would always talk about on his show that him and his missus getting up to madness. He'd always talk about it. So I feel like it was a natural
progression.
Yeah, it just made too much sense.
Yeah, and it makes so much sense.
It's what the streets wanted.
Yeah, exactly. And. But nah, man, nah. I'm just not really interested.
What was the streets ask though? It's the streets.
It's the streets ask. Chris, the streets.
Mad. Mad. The money's there. No, but I remember when we first started this time ago, we had one of the headlines where the girl went to a party. Remember, she was with her boyfriend. She went to a party.
Oh,
and she got clarted out by like a good 5 men in the toilets or something like that.
I remember that.
And then she tried to come back to the boyfriend. She tried to come back to her boyfriend and talk to him, bro. She tried to tell him sorry. She always wanted to do it.
So she clattered 5 men,
in the party.
Her way of making up for it was by saying sorry.
Bro.
But let's go back to the story. She was with the man. I think he's from Catford.
Did he drop her off or something?
He dropped her off to the party. Oh, her brethren.
I bet that's not a man, that's an Uber driver. That's an Uber driver, that's
after
not your man.
After
he's
dropped
her
off, she's in the party, it's getting whatever. She's in the, I think it was in a toilet, in a room or something like that.
There's a couple of, guys, isn't it?
Yeah, and then
It's always niggas, man. It's always us.
That was her fantasy.
I know, but I'm saying it's always us. Leave us alone, man. Stop making us take it. Like,
you can't be putting white girls in front of us,
man.
There's
that's
five
what I'm saying, leave us alone,
bro. And the man's just tagging in.
You say WrestleMania too.
Yeah.
I feel you, man. That's the new day.
And the next thing, you know, she comes back and she's saying to him, this is what I've done, I'm sorry. But we never got the end of the story if he took her back. If he did, then boy.
Bro, I'll be honest. There's no way he took her back. There's no way.
Pretend he dropped her off.
You say that, he dropped her off.
What do you mean he dropped her off?
He dropped her off to the party.
Yeah, but that was before that.
But maybe knowing that's her fantasy, you can't drop a white girl.
Wait,
what
party was it?
House party in Catford.
Oh, yes. I thought like a sex party. It was just
a
house party.
No, just a house party.
That makes it worse.
No, that makes it better for him. That means he definitely didn't know what was going to happen.
No, oh. Yeah, it's true.
Get me?
True.
If he,
she must have not expressed her fantasies to him beforehand, but...
That's what I'm saying.
I still rated her, though.
She might not have known that was a fantasy until she'd seen it. She might have just seen the five black guys and then it just triggered.
And then she's just there like, oh!
Yeah.
Can you send the next one in, please? Imagine. So, yeah. People are crazy out here. People are doing mad stuff. All right. Colin, you had some stuff.
Yeah, it's the thing. Did you see, obviously, the podcast Serial? You heard of it, the podcast
Serial?
Yeah. Basically, it's like the godfather of podcasts, essentially.
I've never heard of that in my life.
Yeah, it's old school. Before your time, actually.
Yeah, before you're born, probably.
Yeah, probably. And then, so basically, it followed the big, big court case of Adnan Syed. And basically, he got put in prison for 22 years
at
17, and he just got out last week.
Did he go on Joe Rogan's
killing
podcast
his girlfriend?
Well?
No, he's only just got out. He's got, no, I don't think so.
There was a guy on Joe Rogan's podcast the other day who also got put away for 20 something years.
No, this is 20. This is 22 years.
For killing his girl?
They
thought he killed his girl.
Yeah. But
he done the OJ thing.
I don't think he did it. And he's just come out. But the thing is, what I was looking
at. Did the glove fit?
No, I didn't. None of it fitted. It was wild. But the thing was.
But it was also the podcast was the reason why he got out.
What?
So them investigating it. The evidence
better
came out.
Better than the police.
Yeah, well,
yeah,
they
100%.
Better than the police and better than the lawyers that were putting them away.
So is this podcast all based around that case?
Yeah.
For 22 years, that's all they talked about.
No, it was just like the first season. That would
be wild. That's what I mean.
That would be mad.
It was just the first season, innit? So it might have been,
they do different seasons,
like,
and different cases.
12 episodes, 20 episodes, whatever. So then they'll do another case about something else. But
they came back to this one, innit?
This is the one that made it big. I think it's part of the times or whatever. But I was thinking, okay, he's been in prison 22 years.
Sorry, thanks.
He's been in prison 22 years. Yeah. He's the last Batman film he saw, right? Was the one with Batman. George Clooney.
Bro, that was Batboy.
Yeah.
You know the one. That was before Batman, bro.
Arnold Schwarzenegger on skates.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Army skates.
Batman.
But the thing is, he's come out being like, oh yeah, okay, let me go to a concert. Let me go see R. Kelly. Well, he can't do that.
Yeah, R. Kelly's got enough.
Bro, R. Kelly, him and R. Kelly swap places, bro.
Don't put words in his mouth.
Him and R. Kelly did a substitution, bro.
Don't do that.
You know the ones.
What do you say?
I said him and R. Kelly swap places, bro.
That's true.
Yeah, no, it is wild.
Tagged in.
And also, wow. like 22 years is a long time. He's only seen the first Matrix film.
Oh shit.
That's what I'm saying. Number you see
four. Don't watch the number four.
That's what I'm saying.
But you know how much? You missed so much, bro. That's a quarter of a century, basically.
Yeah.
That's insane, bro. That means he missed the whole 2000s, bro. Like when he went in jail,
it's
bro.
Mad.
But when he went in jail, he thought the world was going to end.
Oh yeah, man.
He thought the world was going to end and he went in jail.
He on top of buildings and shit. On top of bridges.
He's probably pissed the world didn't end, you know?
Yeah, the whole Y2K thing.
The world didn't end and he's made all them years in there.
See, he didn't even witness 9/11. Fucking hell.
So yeah, so he...
See, he don't know who Osama Bin Laden is.
I'm sure. I don't know if it may... I'm not even going to go there.
I know Osama Bin Laden.
Let's just say the guy's Muslim. So yeah,
But yeah, he's missed bear. But what thing is... Okay, so you've been in
prison...
Where
are you going with this?
Listen,
you've been in prison.
Okay. Wait, just let him land.
Let him land.
You've been in prison. I'll ask you the question. You've been in prison 22 years. Yeah. Right? What's the first three things you do when you get out?
Oh, smashing.
Yeah. But he's Muslim, so and his girlfriend's dead.
He's still... Yeah, poor.
What the fuck is he doing? You poor.
Well, you know what I'm saying, but you know he poor. I can't tell you. You don't know.
A man said, "Who's he gonna smash? His girlfriend's dead."
Oh, that put a bit of a.
That's the reason why he went away. They accused him of killing his girl.
Yeah, but so she's the only one in the world he can smash.
No.
No, but I'm saying
that's probably why I killed her.
The last time that you were smashing. They put you away.
Oh, he's got PTSD.
He can't.
I thought, you said me though.
Yeah, I'm talking about you.
Yeah, sorry, my bad.
Just leave it.
Boring answers, man. Checking the family.
And I'm honest, my man ain't enjoying sex ever again, bro. His girlfriend's gonna hunt him forever, bro.
You think
his girlfriend's gonna let him cheat on her while she's dead? No? We'll meet in the afterlife, bro. Yeah. Are you crazy, bro? Yeah. Every time he's beating, she's gonna be there whispering in his ear. You're coming.
No, but you're saying that he's gonna come out and the first thing he's gonna do is beat. Some of them man are beating inside, bro.
What are you talking about? Beating who?
That's true, bro.
Some of them man are beating inside, bro.
What was the question you asked on the show the other day? About the soap in the shower.
Yeah, I asked him if he dropped soap in jail, and he said, I asked Tiny Beast, if he dropped soap in jail, but he said he had shampoo. But I'm saying, like, bro, you know, you can still drop shampoo, like, you know,
it's still undroppable.
So he was basically on the thing of, like, if it drops, you kind of have to crouch, you know, down.
You can't bend over.
It's not a bend over thing.
Yeah, but maybe he had like one of them. Do you remember the Wiimote? Like, do you remember like the Wiimote strap?
Oh, you need a strap just in case
Yeah,
you got triggered by that, bro. I think you got flashbacks when you asked him that one.
Whoa. I don't know about that one, but yeah.
I'm not trying to mess with him,
but... No, I'm joking.
No, but I'll be honest, if he went 22 years, without getting fucked, that's a clean run.
Yeah?
Yeah.
If he didn't get... I'll be honest,
if he done a life sentence...
I wonder what the tick boxes are of, like, if you didn't do this, you done all right.
That's what I'm saying. If he didn't get dick in his ass in a life sentence, bro, that's a successful. If I ran off for that, bro, you're crazy.
Crap, man.
But if he didn't get fucked, bro. In prison, there is a gal that them do come to prison as well. The ones that work there.
Remember, his girl's dead, bro.
Yeah, I know. I know that, but what I'm saying is in general. I'm not specifically talking about my man. I'm talking about in general. When we was talking to Bobby before, there's the female teachers and stuff in there. People start getting relationships and stuff with them.
Oh, he said that someone was smashing a tutor.
Yeah, and they got in trouble.
I think she got caught for smashing.
Well, in jail.
Yeah.
So she was a teacher going into to help, doing the courses and that.
Rehabilitate them.
Well, she did help rehabilitate them.
Yeah.
But just in a different type of way.
Yeah.
Best behavior.
They were the best behavior.
But there's even, I saw an article on one where the actual, what are they called? The screws, the actual officer. One of the officer ended up with one of the inmates. So they come out and they're all together and that, she's had to get up her job and all them things.
People need to understand, like no matter what establishment you're in, bro, man are man and girl is girl, bro. Like there's nothing you can do to change that, bro. Whether it's an inmate, and an officer, not whether it's a police woman and a criminal, man and girl is girl, bro.
Yeah.
If they both like each other, if he says the right things, bro, you get me. If her hair's tied in a certain way, you get me, bro.
Because who's the basketball coach that cheated on Nia Long?
What?
There's a basketball coach and he's been suspended for the rest of the season.
What, for smashing one of the WNBA?
No, for smashing some two, three chicks he worked with. But his missus is Nia Long. You know Nia Long as in the Nia Long.
I don't know who that is.
You do. Oh. If you saw a picture, you know who she is.
Oh, them ones.
Yeah, bring it up somewhere. I don't know.
Yeah, bring it up. Bruno, right here.
Yeah, here somewhere.
Yeah, do it right there.
Behind the scenes, Bruno.
But no.
Tell her, like, because you come out of nowhere.
You reckon?
One minute you're not in my feed. And now I'm like, who the hell is this guy in my feed? What would you say is like your claim to fame? How you kind of just popped off?
Before I say that, what was the first thing he's seen of me?
The first thing I saw of you was a clip where you said to Chucky and to Poet that they're a man of 50.
And you started
your podcast because when they were your age, that was when N-dubs were popular.
That was
the first clip I
saw. But you've been doing a bit before that, though. I saw you on the Chicken Corner Surfing.
Yeah, well,
and the like, podcast, obviously.
That's what I'm saying.
More recently, you've been on other channels.
Yeah, other different.
So what would you say is like your thing when you popped off?
The M1 podcast, innit? Like obviously those, like, I don't know if you, how much you lot on TikTok, innit? But obviously the M1 podcast, one of the biggest podcasts on TikTok and now I've seen, you get over 100K followers, 40 million views, 5.5 million likes, you get me? That's my way of celebrating the success.
Yeah.
But now, what I was going to say, that's how most people knew, man. You get me? Like, whenever people stop me on the street, it's mainly because of the TikTok. You get me? The M1 podcast TikTok.
How was that when the first time someone just stopped you on the street? Was that mad?
Bro, it was weird, bro. I can't lie to you because, like, I didn't know nothing about TikTok, bro. Like, because I don't edit shit, bro. I just turn up, I talk my shit, and I go home, bro. So it's like, I'll be walking on the street, and I'll come up to you and be like, yo, you're the guy from TikTok. But it's like, because them times I didn't even have TikTok on my phone, so I thought it was just being racist, bro. I thought another black TikToker, bro. You know the ones? He said, nah, you're on the podcast TikTok. I'm like, oh shit, yeah, that's me, you know? I'm like, yeah, that's me, you know the one. So then obviously, I'm like, my brother Mods, he's the one that does the TikTok, innit? And he's the one that's like, letting him know, like, yo, like, the thing's actually popping off on TikTok, you feel me? But before then, I didn't know shit about TikTok, bro. So I never in my life thought TikTok was going to be the thing that made me become known, you get me?
Yeah.
That's okay. And then literally from there, you've just been getting called up for different things.
Yeah, literally, but that's what I'm saying. Like, everything just like, I don't know what it is, but like people always expect me to have like some mad story about how I met this guy and he put me on. And like, bro, it's literally, and I tell you, bro, man literally done the M1 podcast.
For years?
No, for years.
How many years? How long?
The M1 podcast, we going on since 2019, yeah?
Okay.
But I only became a part of it last year, bro.
Oh.
Yeah, literally like a year and a half ago. Yeah, and a bit ago. Literally.
So what was you doing before that then?
I was doing radio.
Oh, okay.
I had a radio show there's a radio station in Manchester called Pi Radio, innit?
Yeah.
I used to like interviewing up and coming artists from Manchester.
That's where you're like,
you get me? That's where I kind of
your reps
like,
in.
Yeah. That literally, but that's like my training ground, you get me? And obviously, like the first thing that like probably popped off for me, I don't know if you've like, seen that music channel called Cold Socials. Have you seen it?
There's that rap channel,
yeah. And basically, they used to do this series where it's like they'll pick an artist and they'll invite fans of the artist onto the show to debate different questions about the artist, you get me? So like, I went on a Diggity one, for example, and there was a clip at the very end, where like, obviously, it'll be a thing where like, they'll say, if you agree, stand there. VillyTheGoat stand there, yeah. Mm. And there was a clip of me where like everyone's on that side.
And then you're the only one on that side. Like, I've seen that, yeah, them videos.
I was the only one on that side. Nah, not even, bro, because we're blindfolded. So we don't know what to get me.
Yeah, I remember seeing all them on Insta.
And everyone's onto me arguing. And because of the way I held my ground, yeah, that's what kind of got a lot of traction. Like, a lot of the pages started posting it, like, oh, what do you lot think of this? Even Twitter, that's how I kind of became known on Twitter. Obviously, before that, the only thing I was really known on was Clubhouse, you get me? So it literally went from
Clubhouse. Yeah, that didn't last long, did it?
Yeah, I mean, lockdown ended and everyone came outside.
Yeah, everyone got a job again.
Literally, furlough money ran out. So.
But that's also, it was also a time though where you could build a podcast and build on TikTok. Like loads of people grew shows during the pandemic where everyone was at home.
Yeah, but that's the opposite. I kind of like started growing just as soon as the pandemic ended, you get me? When things were calming down is when I kind of started growing into things, you get me?
You've done pretty well then in 2 years to like go from nothing to like boom.
Yeah, no.
What do you think is different about your show compared to like the other shows, like the No Behaviors and the Filthy Fellas? And like, what do you think? Because you always make some distinctions. Why are you
like, already
trying to like clear your throat and get ready to cuss people?
No, I'm not even cussing anyone. I'm trying to think what sets us apart. You know what it is, yeah? Obviously, man are from different walks of life anyway, innit? Like Mugs and Loons, they're like OG from East London. They've been in the streets, been to jail, been through this, that, and they've come out and they're just kind of trying to chill now, you get me? Whereas me, I'm more of like this excited younger from out of town that just doesn't care about anyone. You get what I'm trying to say to you? I feel like it's just an energy thing, you feel me? I feel like the energy that I've kind of brought to the scene is kind of unique, and I feel like a lot of people kind of felt like it was missing, like a personality with like me was missing, you get what I'm trying to say?
Yeah. Obviously you said you got like 50 different names, but where did Billy the Goat come from?
Obviously my name is Bilal, innit? Cause I'm Muslim. And then obviously I'm not related to my man. They've done 22.
Yeah, I was gonna say, because you did ask about 9/11 and also.
I don't know all about them and there, but yeah, fucking my name is Bilal, innit? And obviously when I went to college, I had a lot of white friends in college, innit? So they used to always just call me Billy. Mm. And at first I hated it, I can't lie to you. I never used to like it, innit? But eventually I just embraced it, innit? So when I came to Clubhouse now, I created a username for Clubhouse, yeah. It's like, I didn't want to call my government name because like everyone on there has their tags and that, you know what I'm trying to say? Like, so obviously, I just made it Billy the Goat, literally. Like, I couldn't even give you an explanation. I just added the goat.
Oh, so there was no thought really, like,
I just literally added the goat.
It's a play on words as well.
Yeah, literally, Billy the Goat, you get me? Yeah. I wish I had a story behind it, but I don't.
No, because when you search, there's many things that come up. Like, there's I'm not going to promote her, but there is a woman out there that has loads of goats.
Yeah.
She got mad back and she's just, let me land. There's some black woman out there in America, yeah. She's got body, I'm not going to lie. I saw her today and I saw her the other day when I was searching Billy the Goat, like, and she came up, but
she accidentally went back to her profile.
No, I was searching again today, innit? I was looking on.
That's a finger slip.
A little bit lax.
Bro, I think I know what you're talking about. Yeah, bro. Imagine there's a farmer.
She's got Billy goats.
But there's a farmer lady, bro, that got a goat that had a goat called Billy the Goat, bro. That my man was so famous, bro. He died. No, I'll be honest, he died recently, yeah.
What, the goat?
Brother. Yeah, the goat died, yeah, thankfully. Bro, imagine. I'm happy. Because he's not a bro.
She's like, he's messaging.
Is he taking your numbers?
That's what I'm saying. The nigga was trending when he died, bro. Nigga was trending. I'm like, I see Billy the Goat trending. But what do you think is going through my head, bro? I thought I got cancelled, bro. I thought, like, what the fuck happened? What the fuck happened, bro? Then I've gone in it and man has posted RIP Billy the Goat.
Did anyone tag you by accident?
Nah, I think someone just screenshot and sent it to me like, yo, Billy, what happened? You get me? Bro, man's going through the feed. I'm thinking, bro, like, why is everyone crying over this goat, bro, when there's an actual goat here that's working hard? Like, you niggas are sleeping on me. Yeah. They want to cry over this goat. Say nothing, bro. Yeah. But yeah, if the tables are turning now anyway, I'm smoking on that Billy pack right now. Mm. You get me? fuck that goat, bro.
I would love it.
So obviously you're saying, you're Muslim, yeah?
Yeah, mashallah.
Okay, so obviously, you know, you use seasoning, which I appreciate.
What do you mean?
You season your food. You season your food. You're gonna be mad at you season your food, innit? Like, you know what I'm saying? You're eating. Why are you even busting up with it?
Wait. Let me just say this, yeah. I'm just trying to work out my brain how it went from, yeah, you're Muslim to, yeah, you season your food. Like, what the fuck does my religion have to do with what I do to my food, bro? I'm so confused right now, bro. Okay, but well, why did you start the sentence with, yeah, you're Muslim? I don't know.
Okay, for example, right? I know you season your food, yeah?
Why? Where are you going with this?
But I don't know if he seasons his food.
Okay.
Wait.
So I'm still waiting for you to tie back to be Muslim, bro.
Because obviously, you know, that part of the world, you know, that's where some of the best seasoning comes from.
Yeah, but I'm not from that part of the world, though.
Yeah, but like it comes in with the culture,
it's
with
like,
the heritage.
It's like seasoning comes from Mecca, bro. It doesn't work like that.
It does come from Mecca.
Yeah, but I'm not from there, though.
Yeah.
I'm Nigerian.
You're Nigerian, innit?
Yeah. Well, to what the Niger don't season?
Obviously.
Well, that's what I'm saying, but
you were talking about the, Mecca and that side of the world, bro. I'll be honest, you're all over the place.
He's cool. Yeah, he's cool. You know what I mean, though,
you
man.
You fucked yourself.
No, wait a second. You know what? Let me
listen.
The thing is, let's do a vote for the audience. Does anyone?
No, I'll be honest. I actually have no clue what you're talking about. Like, I don't know what you mean. Like, I don't know.
The funniest thing is, yeah, Colin, every time you try to ask something, everyone's jumping in on you. I kind of get where you was trying to go.
You know where I was going, man.
Let me set up now, man. I see what's going on. I'm ready now. Let's go. Late night London, yeah? Yeah, say nothing, man. Am I the first out of London guest you've had on there?
Say again?
No. Am I the first out of London guest?
No. We've had one across the world. We've had
North.
North.
Oh, no. But
who's you?
They're virtual, though. They're virtual.
Real. No, live
you are the first live
in the
flesh.
Live in the flesh,
Billy the Goat from North, man. You get me? Late night London with touchdown. Yeah. You get me? Now, finish your fucking question.
I told you he'll feel a bit halfway through. I told you. It's like,
go on. So the top three, basically, let me get to the point. I was going to ask you what your top three seasonings were, innit?
Okay. Can I answer?
Yeah, of course you can.
Maggi.
Yeah? Okay.
I see you take it serious.
Maggi and Maggi.
Yeah, it's just Maggi and extra Maggi. Yeah, is that?
Yeah. Did I mention Maggi as well?
Yeah.
You know, Maggi is so versatile, bro.
Can't go wrong.
Like, Maggi's like its own, like, Avengers universe of seasoning, bro. Like,
it's all the stones.
That's what I'm saying.
It's all the stones.
People will think that Maggi just a one thing, but that's how I know you're not cultured, bro. Mm. You get what I'm trying to say? That's how I know your mom's a rookie. No offense, but your mom's a rookie if you think Maggi is one seasoning, bro. Mm. There's a bare different types of Maggi, bro.
The liquid one.
You get what I'm trying to say?
So I'm saying
the reason I say Maggi is because that includes everything, bro. Mm. You feel me? No matter what you're feeling, no matter what you're eating, slap Maggi on it. Even if you're drinking Tango, put Maggi in it. No matter what it is, put Maggi in it, bro. Mm. I promise you're gonna taste nice, bro.
Yeah.
So since Mr.
That
Ennis
was a
has started,
mad way to get to
I don't know.
I don't think it was.
Anyway, I'm gonna get straight to the point.
So
yeah?
How the fuck did that God do with Islam, bro? Like, I'm so confused, bro.
You fucked yourself.
The only way I can link him back is Maggi is a creation from God, and God.
He saved you.
I seen where it's going.
So since he started the top three, three selected, basically. Yeah. What's your top three cultural foods from Nigeria?
Oh,
let's go. Top three.
I have to go for suya.
Mm.
You know what suya is?
No, I'm not too
Why'd
sure.
Why'd you say
mm?
Yeah.
I hate niggas.
No. Any real nigga would have said.
I gave a fake nod of like.
Any real nigga would have said, oh, what's that? Like he ate it today. You said it like he ate it today, bro.
I was in. You was like soya.
Soya is like.
You have to say it like that as well. You have to.
Yep. Bro, I wouldn't feel right saying suya. You know what I'm saying?
I wouldn't understand you.
You know what I'm saying? This ain't BBC News, bro. Like, this is late night London podcast, bro. You feel me? Suya.
But what is it? You was gonna explain.
Suya is just meat. It's like whoa. It's like it can either be beef or lamb, yeah.
Okay.
And it's like it obviously is cooked, yeah. But it's like the main thing about it is that it's spice. It's like riddled in spice. I know my Nigerians are gonna be laughing at the way I'm describing it right now. I don't know how to describe this shit, but I don't know if it tastes nice, innit?
I think I've had that.
If you go on Google Images,
one of my friends' dad has a restaurant. He has a Nigerian restaurant.
It's like spicy beef.
I had it and it burnt out my mouth. Mad.
Yeah, it was probably that still. Yeah. Obviously you lot know fufu, innit?
Yes.
But different types of fufu. I like pounded jam. And then obviously the stew that I like is called Efo.
So it's like vegetable, kind of. You get me?
It's like seaweed and bare meat. I'm the worst at describing shit, bro. All I know is that it's leng, bro. Mm. You know what I mean? Just take my word for it, bro. It's leng, bro. You get me? Pounded jam with Efo. I'm a number three. Oh, this is techie, you know. This is mad.
Take your time.
I probably have to say moi moi.
Oh, I've had moi moi. I've had my from Peckham.
From Peckham. It's authentic.
No,
No, Peckham, I'll be honest, Peckham is like Lagos 2.0, bro.
I work with people from like all the African continents, and I'm telling you now, literally, they get food and they're like to me, it's not even like I can eat it or I'm not going to eat it. They sit down. Everyone gets their little packs of food and they're like, yo, come and sit down. Caribbean
that's
wear, come and sit down.
Just...
That's what I'm saying. And
so that's what I'm saying. I've heard the names, but I didn't know what part was what.
Okay, so what's my mind?
What?
That's what I said.
I don't know.
You heard what I said.
You did this yourself. You did this. I've never seen this before.
I don't know where it was, but it was nice.
No. That's not good enough.
Bro, my mind is like beans, an egg, but it's like, mash up into some orange thing, bro. And it's
I wouldn't be able to describe that either, to be fair.
I just know it tasted nice. I was shocked. I thought it was going to taste butters and it tasted nice.
Yeah, it doesn't look nice though. No. But yeah, man. We got all my Nigerians, especially my Yorubas out there. You get me, man?
Have you seen that white guy that goes around and he goes into shops and speaks Yoruba to people?
I ain't seen that. I don't want to see that shit.
He basically learns the different languages.
So he's not from there? He just learns the language?
He's a white American guy.
Okay.
And is it Yoruba?
Yeah, you got Yoruba.
Yoruba. So he goes into shops around London. He came here and you go into the shop and just start speaking Yoruba. So, and they're like some of them are like cussing him in the language. Like, what the fuck's this guy doing in there?
Yeah, I think my mother showed me that clip.
And he puts the captions.
Oh, what they're actually saying and what he's saying.
And then he starts speaking to them and they're like, what the fuck? He asks for the particular food that they don't think he knows, and he does it on purpose, isn't it?
Yeah. I think my sister showed me that before.
He gets
but me
mad
personally,
views.
Yeah, I don't really. I've never been a fan of that kind of shit. You know, I feel like black people. Yeah, I feel like we get too excited when white people can do things that we can do. You know what I mean?
Give me an example. As black people, bro,
there's certain things that we think only we can do, bro.
Like what?
Like speaking Yoruba, bro. Like Nigerians, people think that you have to be Yoruba to speak Yoruba, but it's just a language. Same way niggas can learn French, bro. Same way niggas can learn Arabic. Same way niggas can learn Yoruba. You get what I'm trying to say to you, bro? Mm. Especially if it's a white guy that's grown up around Yoruba people, bro. Like, eventually, he might be interested in it. You get what I'm trying to say?
But he gets 2 million views for it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's why I don't like, man, I like making bread of just the fact you can speak Yoruba, bro. Okay, if I now learn, what's a white language, bro? English. Brother, where's my 2 million views for speaking English, bro? This ain't my language.
Yeah.
I'm African, bro.
If you're black and you go to like a country like Russia and start talking Russian, they're not going to talk to you.
Brother, you think David was getting taken down, bro? Putin is saying delete this shit before I explode the app, bro. Are you crazy, bro?
Putin's like, I got
this. That's what I'm saying. That's why when I see the white people doing the black,
it's crazy because the same thing is in China. When he goes to China, they get like all excited and they're like, can I have a photo with you? Just because he's speaking their language. Yeah. It's just kind of crazy when you think about it.
A photo with a man, just because a language you can speak, bro.
Yeah.
It's a bit mad.
Well, I'll be honest.
When you put it that way, it's a bit mad.
Yeah, crazy.
Back to the top three selections.
What's the two, the curry goat or?
Yeah,
Calm down.
There's not anyone land today, innit?
That was my problem earlier.
That was your
problem. I'm just going to ask you for celebrities, because there is many, but you know about TikTok now, innit? Yeah. So let's go on TikTok, because you were talking about earlier. So your main three male celebrities on TikTok, what would you say your top three is?
Can I put myself in there?
No, let's not put yourself in there.
He's gassed, so let him put him in there.
No, because it will be Billy the Goat.
Billy the Goat, Bilal, Starboy Billy. You know what I mean? But now, fucking my top three male, I'll be honest, like if I told you like I'll watch male TikTokers like that, I'd be lying to you, bro. But what's that? Am I looking long on there? I just see myself in a clone, but I'm kind of glowing slightly, you know. I can't lie to you, but yeah.
They've learned to like black people.
It took us a couple episodes.
It's compulsory.
That's why that light's up there.
Male celebrity. This feels kind of sus, bro. I can't lie to you.
My score is cool.
Who are you following? Who's in your feed?
That makes even more sus, bro. Okay, but male celebrities on TikTok. Oh, obviously, you know PK Humble, innit?
Yeah.
I probably say him, he's funny. Oh, that's my guy as well. Fucking, who do I watch? Oh, you know, you might not know him because he's a bit younger. He's like my age. There's this guy, he's like Marley, innit? His name's Max Kadar, and he does like Omegle videos, innit? So basically, it'll be a thing where, like, you know what Omegle is?
Yeah.
Basically, it'll be a thing.
Do you guys know what that is?
No.
I knew they didn't.
He was explaining it though.
Omegle. Basically, he does videos where he's dropping game on girls, innit?
Okay.
And basically, he'll do a thing where it's like, he'll watch a video, of a guy explaining like how to get girls, and then the guy will give him a line to say, yeah. And then he'll drop that line on the girl, but he'll mess up the line so bad. He'll fumble it so badly. But this shit is so funny, bro. That shit is hilarious. So Max Kadar, definitely. I'm at number three. The speed count?
Yeah, could do.
Yeah, I'll say speed 100%. That's my number one, in fact. Speed's number one.
Okay.
So, yeah,
So, out of them three, which one would be the business link? Which one would be the man them link? And which one would you write off? And when I say write off, like... Business link. Yeah.
What do you mean business link?
So like, which one would be the one that's like out of the three people that you said
you'd work with?
Yeah, you do a video with.
Speed 100% speed 100%. That's gonna happen. Remember, I said that as well. I'm gonna do a video with Speed.
This is the exclusive. Yes. And then man them link, as in your
PK, because that's already my guy. Yeah.
And then you're writing off.
Sorry, Max, man. Sorry.
Getting
but bro, with that kind of game, you can't be around me, bro. We see when I'm going on my steps out late.
You got game though. You got game.
Of course, bro.
What's the line that? What's your approach?
Bro, you see.
You ain't swiping left or right? Or is that
bro, I'm 19. How can I be on Tinder at 19, bro? Like, that's
you don't need none of that.
I'm asking. We're old, innit? We don't know how the game is for the younger generation.
Bro, I can't like see when man ask me like what are my lines and that. I've never understood that. I don't have lines, bro. Like, it just depends on what's going on.
It's
bro.
Just game.
That's what I'm saying, bro. Game is about like adapting to the surroundings, bro. Like if you have like lines you always say, that's not a game, that's a script, bro. You know what I mean? You're an actor, you're not a player, you're an actor, bro. You know what I'm trying to say to you, bro? Like it's just about what's going on, bro, about the vibe. And then you just talk to them just based on what's going on. You get what I'm trying to say? Like you don't have like a written four bar. You know, like certain men have like a written four bar that they always use, bro, but they never get a wheel up. It's like loud, bro. Like you're always missing the drop every night, bro, and you're still spitting the same bars. Loud it, bro. You know what
this one's easy.
That sounds
this...
a lot more advanced than I was expecting, if I'm being honest. I thought the younger generation were just all like tech. That seems more advanced than I
remember. But you know how it is back in the day. Like, sorry to interrupt you. Do you know what? If you've got the juice, you've got the juice.
Yeah.
I don't want to talk about you.
Right, bruv, don't talk about your stories. I can...
Let's go.
Listen. All right, you want to go?
We're not doing that.
I ain't gonna lie. So I was token white boy. So my only way of doing it was I was the only breakdancer white guy. And that was my hook.
This is before diversity.
Yeah.
Wait. Don't say so. Let's slow down. You're telling me you used to move to girls by breakdancing?
No, they would come to me.
It's true.
I want to know the girls, like the level.
Because they see the white guy, they're like not expecting it. They see me
dancing.
All types of dancing. Yeah. I'm not spinning on my head and being like, what's going on?
So I want to know, were you one of them body poppers that did this bullshit? I hate that. I've been that's my least favorite kind of people. I hate that shit, man. I hate that.
And loads of other guys would hate it, but it would work.
How long ago was this though?
What, like 10 years ago?
Okay, back then it's acceptable.
That was what was me. You were all more confident. Mm. Like you were confident. I think you were pretty confident. For me, I would just dance and then the girls would come to me. And it worked. It did work.
Crazy,
but it's similar to
that. No, but I'll be honest, what's the quality of the girls that were going up to him saying though?
They were quality, honestly.
Premier League?
I ain't gonna lie. I will say that there were some of the levels where I was shook.
Swear down.
There ones where
the clubs that we was going to as well, we weren't going to no little big clubs. We're getting invited to some big boy places.
But you know it's the opposite now, bro. Like niggas that be dancing in the middle of the dance.
Because they're
bro.
Everywhere now.
Back in the day, it was a few of us. It's different though. Now you can do it. Man are out here doing TikTok dances and stuff like that. When we was proper dancing in the club, we were getting called by promoters. Like the dance floor's dead.
Just to freestyle.
Like we need you to freestyle there.
You're basically lap dancers.
We didn't even realize.
He just exposed us.
Crazy.
I know it worked for me in carnival as well, boy.
How do you mean?
Getting down low and dancing up with the gal them. There was loads of them that were jumping on me. I was swarmed sometimes.
Carnival was crazy. When you lot came off stage after performing on carnival.
That is crazy. So the dancing niggas got it like that.
We used to.
But now it's saturated across everywhere.
We used to dance as well.
No.
Exactly,
no,
I knew it. But you ain't built like a dancer.
No, we are
stiff hips. You used to dance, bro.
Listen, I'm done.
You.
I listen,
you used to dance.
Yeah, bro. Yeah,
bro.
I used to be loose.
I can't remember zooming on my man. Told me he's good dancer.
Listen. Too stiff.
I'm not stiff, man. I ain't stiff.
Colin could do splits.
Eh?
What? Yeah.
You can do the splits.
I ain't still, bro. Listen, you need to relax.
Colin, have you ever done the splits on the podcast?
Allow it.
You're an idiot.
I'm not doing it.
You could do the splits, bro.
Yeah.
You know, like, that has to be an empty room for you to do that.
Yeah.
I'm not.
Because your legs will stretch. No, look how long your legs are, bro. Look how long your legs are. Brother, that's taking the whole perimeter of the room, bro. That has to be an empty room. You might have to watch for a bird's eye view, bro.
Yeah.
But no, I haven't done it. I ain't doing it on the podcast. That's not.
I don't want to see that shit.
Yeah, that's not getting.
I just ate it, but I don't.
Anyway, so that was my approach, and then you just were just on a. We're married now, so the stories can't. I don't know if the stories can come out on the podcast.
Are you all married?
No, yeah. But the thing about it is, with my thing, it's the same thing like what Billy was saying. I could just talk.
I can talk.
I can speak. I can do whatever. It's however it started, however it was back and forth.
You actually had game.
No, but even to do with my wife, like, we didn't even like each other the first time we met. It was like people were trying to put us together and stuff, and I was just doing my own thing. I didn't even think my missus was gonna talk to me when I actually tried to spit game to her, because on that same night I went to a casino where we was having drinks, and then I left her with the group that I was with. One of my friends tried to talk to her, and I went off with about 5 or 6 different girls to the casino, and she was just walking away thinking, this guy's some idiot, bro. He thinks he's a gallus. And then next time when I spoke to her, kind of was a bit techie.
She was like, I was right.
Yeah, but we had a little conversation, and then yeah, it went from there. So
so youngers are more advanced, bro. I like, because we were on that one.
I'll be honest, not everyone my age has got a game, bro. I'll be honest with you, man.
Well, I'm going to ask you as well about your age group, yeah? Not to belittle anything, but what's the online game? Do you have to have a good online game as well? Yeah, that's where.
So we didn't need any of that.
That's the difference.
But I'll be honest, like, even to a girl via text, yeah, it takes a different skill set then move into a real life. You know the ones, bro.
Because
at the end of the day, bro, people will think, yeah, that it's very easy moving to a girl online. But it's not, though, bro. Because especially if it's a girl that's attractive, you know how it is, bro. Your DM requests are full of them, bro. So number one, bro, you can't just be another idiot in the DMs just saying what everyone else is saying, you feel me? I'm not going to give nothing away.
Wait, give us this, though. Who slid into your DMs and what have they said? Like, what's the best? Like, let's say their name. What's the best? Has anyone slid into your DMs since like you've been popping off? I'm sure more girls have started sliding into DMs.
I'm trying to remember.
You know what you mean?
I'm trying to remember.
You're trying to hunt yourself up. What's the best way a girl slid into your DMs?
I'll be honest with you, girls ain't got no game, bro. That's just the truth. Girls got no game whatsoever, bro. Girl,
so when
it's like
the DMs, what
game,
is it? Hi,
bro.
How are you?
It's like,
what is it?
Bro, it will be like some bullshit, bro. Like they'll just pop up to one of your stories, yeah? And just say something that's not even related to what you posted. You know what I mean? Like, Mal pulls a picture. You post a picture of your shoes, they'll say, oh yeah, that's a nice jacket. Like, what the fuck are you talking about? Nigga, these are shoes, but you know, that's just an example, bro. Mm. Like, they'll just post up, but like, what girls do when they like you on social media, they just randomly start popping up to you. Like, randomly just start texting you all the time, like, start talking to you all the time, you get me? And then after a while, bro, they just expect you to, like, get the hint that I like you, you feel me? Like, that's why I say girls ain't got no game, because they never make their intentions clear, bro. How much times that...
Give them some advice, then. What should they do if they want to come?
Bro,
the same way
a man will tell you, yo, I'm feeling you, whatever. Do the same to a man that you're feeling. You know them ones, bro. Mm. Why are you fucking...
I was talking about this before. It's a deeper thing. Yeah. Girls are not brought up or set up in a way to be able to move to anyone.
They're rejection,
isn't it? Or to take rejection, that's what I was about to say.
Yeah, but they're always set up to be the ones to receive. They're not just set up to be the ones to, like...
That's why
not all of them are like that, though.
So I'm in a club, right? And I'm with my girlfriend, now wife, and I'm dancing with this girl and the red dress.
I don't know.
You do know. All right. So, and then she's basically, we're dancing and whatever. She gets all like, she's getting a bit too frisky. Then I'm like, I had to let her know, like, listen, I'm
with someone.
Do you know what I mean? And then she was like, She was like, come here, like, to the corner. So I was like, this is, don't take me to the dark corner. It's not gonna, like, I already told you what it is, isn't it? And she went, listen, I don't want to be your friend. I don't want to talk to you. I just want you to fuck me. Can you do that? Can you give me that? That's the first time in my life. That's the first. And I was honestly, I was so shocked. I was like, I've never heard it. Like, and she was a lawyer, like a high flying lawyer in like in bank.
Yeah.
And I was like, I think I didn't say nothing for about 2 minutes.
Yeah.
I was just like, and I remember coming over to actually I can't say the names. I know. Mm-mm. I came over to the boys. Yeah, don't say the name. And I was like, boy, have I got a girl for you lot over here. And then, I try not to say the names, man. Then basically, we leave the club.
This thing is a born snitch, you know. I clocked it. What? This guy's trying so hard not to say the name. Like, it's natural to him to say the name. Don't catch a case with my man.
Anyway, one of the guys was like, we came out of the club and I looked over. One of the guys was getting head for her in the car.
And then as you do.
And another one, and a different guy, one of our friends, took her home. But I think to the point, that was the first time I've ever heard a girl just be like,
yeah, that's
direct.
No, it's like, I was just like, yeah. Whoa.
Jeez. But that's what I'm saying. But like, that's why I said girls got no game, bro. Because that's not game.
That's not even game.
That's not game.
She's like right
to
the point.
That's borderline assault, bro. Because it might break my chin, bro.
Imagine if I went outside right now and said to a girl.
That's what I'm saying. Imagine I went outside right now and said to a girl, yo, let me fuck you. But you know what's going to happen, bro?
Yeah,
22
yeah.
years like my man.
Yeah.
Going to end up like my man, bro. Literally, yeah, it's peak, bro. That's why I say girls ain't got no game, because it's either that they don't shoot a shot at all, or when they do try to shoot a shot, they just do long ball and no finesse, no build-up play, no nothing. Right. It's just straight from the centre-back straight to the striker, and that's it.
That sounds like your FIFA game, Colin.
Yeah, no, you need to relax.
Straight long ball, isn't it? Nah, hoping someone's going to go on, yeah.
Literally, bro. It's Sam Allardyce in 0-15, bro. Just long ball after long ball, bro. No finesse to the game whatsoever, bro.
So let me land on the last one, yeah? Top three selected. What's the top three celebrity females? And that can be from anywhere. Insta, TikTok, Twitter.
I thought you were saying TikTok.
No.
Let me just do TikTok.
No, if you can do TikTok. He's got TikTok. I might not know them.
On TikTok, obviously, there's...
Yeah, sure. Yeah, who's that? Yeah.
Write them down, Bruno. We've got to tag them in.
This is killing me. Obviously, on TikTok, yeah, I got a very lovely friend. Her name's Miss Sandy Baby. She does skits, like just comedy skits. I'm trying to say she's definitely one of my favorite
females
to watch on TikTok. Mm. There's also another female TikToker, and goes by the name of Shio Bolu. Yeah, she does like comedy videos in it. So like, how can I describe it? Like basically, you know, like them people that just talk to the phone and tell story time.
Yeah.
Story time. That's what she does. She's mad funny as well. And number three.
He's been really nice about this, isn't he? He's been safe. He's just very smart, these answers.
Yo. We're number three, there's another female presenter.
Mm. Okay.
She does public videos and she posts them on TikTok, and her name's Louisa J. Mm. So yeah, I'm a big fan of her content as well.
Mad. All right, cool. Before we go on, yeah? So I've got Mary. Impregnate.
Oh shit.
Where is it going?
And
left?
Swerve.
It went left.
Out of those three. That went left. Oh shit.
I impregnate all three of them?
Nah. Mary, impregnate, and Swerve.
Mary. Oh. This is crazy. Like, you know what it is, yeah? Saying impregnate, that's not even a compliment to them. That's like right. Like,
I just say have a baby with.
No, yeah, have a baby with.
Like, that's the same thing, bro. That didn't make it better. Marry, I can't lie, I'd marry all of them, bro. I actually would.
So you're on a poly thing, the polygamy thing.
Polyamorous.
Yeah, polyamorous.
I would, all of them. All at once.
Because technically you can do
all. Answer the question, man. Come on, you got this. Think.
But you know what it is though, like. I don't know, like, how do I separate who I'd marry and who I'd impregnate? That's what I don't get.
I get it because how would you separate?
What?
Who? Because I could bear in mind, I don't know either them personally like that, so I don't know who'd make a like who I'd get along more with.
Make a judgment.
I can only go based off looks.
Who do you reckon will make the good babies?
Okay, so if we're not talking about
deeper things, like if we get
okay, I'm marrying the Louisa J. I'm having a baby with Sandy Baby. Oh, this is crazy. Oh, this is insane. I need to detail how insane this is. Bro. Yeah, let's next question.
And so yeah, Eric, he didn't even say the last one.
He didn't want to write her off.
Next question. Yo. Listen, I love all of you. All of my black queens on TikTok. I love all of you, man.
That was amazing.
I wouldn't swerve any of you.
Yeah, it's too late now.
All right, cool. So this is one of your questions anyway, but like, are you, what are you, man, PlayStation, Xbox? Because I don't play games.
It has to be PlayStation, bro.
Xbox all day.
Oh my day. I mean, no, it makes sense though that you're Xbox though.
Well, because I'm white.
Nah, because I feel like.
Why?
Xbox niggas are always kind of like alternative. You know the one?
Yeah,
I feel like Xbox.
Like, you used to have like big chains and stuff and like, I mean, skaters.
You're Xbox too! No, he's like, you're
PlayStation, bro.
I feel like
PlayStation.
You started with Xbox.
Me personally, remember that. Like, I don't know if you like when I was younger, like, that was one of the conversation starters, bro. Like, do you have PlayStation or Xbox? Before I know your name, before I know where you're from, before I know how old you are, I don't give a fuck about none of that. PlayStation or Xbox. If a man said Xbox, I can't trust you no more, bro.
There's a limit
on our friendship.
Yeah, but you're
bro.
A PlayStation, you can't even talk to each other. Your comms are shit.
Bro, I'll be honest. I feel like Xbox niggas are the type of niggas to like eat pussy and not beat. You know them ones, bro. You know them ones. That's Xbox niggas for you. Xbox niggas are the type of guys just to go to a girl's house, eat ass, and then go home. Master Uber Eats, bro. They just go in there just to eat and going home. Like, that's Xbox
they
niggas.
They're just
kind of wet. I've always found them kind of wet. Like, what do you mean your pad is there, one of the sticks is there, and the other one's up there? Like, why are you playing like this for? Like, what the fuck? Like, is that Nintendo DS or something, bro? Like, that's why I've never trusted Xbox niggas, bro. Like, I've never trusted them ever. And how the fuck do you go from Xbox 360 to Xbox One, bro? What about the other? How is the next one after one? After 361, bro. What happened to the other 359, bro? At least the PlayStation PlayStation makes sense, bro.
PS1,
2, 3, 4. What do you mean you went from 360 to 1, bro? Allow me, bro. But obviously, Microsoft, if you want to sponsor me, shout me, innit?
To help you out.
Disclaimer.
Get me, but obviously, I've always been PlayStation through and through. I've started.
Never Xbox at all, just always play.
Nah, because when I was younger, my cousin had a PS2.
What were you playing on there? What were you playing?
Pezzle 6, imagine that.
Okay.
But I was in about 2006, bro. I was a broke heap, bro. I was playing Pezzle 6 in 2013.
Oh, God.
Pezzle 6 in 2013,
that's
bro.
That's wild.
On the PS2.
Struggling.
Are you deep in it, bro?
Yeah, no, hold on.
Do you still have Scott lead? You have HDMI back then?
Yeah, I think so.
But nah, then, I had HDMI.
Yeah. And then
that's when you're proper young, when you had Scott lead.
Yeah. I had HDMI.
Oh,
do you remember them cables with the three colours?
Yeah, that's a Scott.
That's
yeah,
what I'm on about.
No, that's what I'm saying. A man my age should have remembered that. That's how you know I was broke, bro. That's how I was broke.
That's what I'm saying.
That's not my generation. I was behind in time, bro.
TVs don't even make them with those connections anymore.
Literally, bro. But I'm going to say that my mum got us a PS3, yeah.
Nice.
But don't say nice, bro. We didn't have no games. We're just playing demos, bro. They're just demos, bro.
I feel you, know. It was bro, like that. No, it was
bro,
like
bro.
That.
You
I
see understand. The FIFA 14 World Cup demo, brother. That was the bro. I bashed
but
those
6 minutes
shit,
were
bro.
Wicked, weren't it?
Oh my days, bro. But we only had like 4 teams, bro. In my head, that was the whole world,
over
bro.
And over again.
We had Brazil. Wait, where was it? It was in. It was in Brazil, innit? Yeah, we had Brazil.
We had debate teams.
We had Ivory Coast, and we had some 2 European teams, innit, bro? I was playing with Ivory Coast actually, because they had Dumbia, they had Drogba, bro. The Ivory Coast team was so sweaty, bro. It was insane, bro. But yeah, and then obviously I've upgraded to PS4, and then yeah, I've not even got a PS5 yet. But yeah, I've just been PlayStation 3 and 3 my whole life. Like, I don't trust Xbox niggas, bro. I can't lie to you, man. Okay. You lot are funny to me.
You lot are more gamers, so you lot can carry on. That I don't know.
I've got all consoles, innit? We play all
I do have them both.
I have
now.
All consoles because you lot play certain games on those that are only on PlayStation, so I got to have both.
Oh, and then, yeah.
But
yeah.
Obviously, but same thing. I had a chipped PlayStation. Do you know what that is?
No, chipped.
This is how broke I was.
Yeah. Joe broke or something.
So you basically opened the top.
Oh, I know what you mean.
You put a spring
with
in.
The spring in.
I never knew. Yeah,
yeah. So you stayed open. Yeah. You put a boot disc.
This is PS1. The big grey one. I'm about to break it. Yeah, not the
disc. You put a boot disc. It boots up the thing. You take the disc out whilst it's spinning, which is a madness. And then you throw in the fake game and then you play.
PS1 must have looked breezy. That must have looked like a microwave or something, bro.
They were small. Was it small?
No, it was tiny.
Because I was small back then. So, but that was hard.
No, but compared to how the PlayStations and that are now, they're literally hard drives now. Beforehand, it was just
there was a guy in the ends who sold fake PlayStation games from his yard. So you go knock on the door, give you like A4 paper with the list of games. It was like £2 a game.
Sounds like you're picking up food.
And he'll pick up. And he'll
pick up. Imagine, like a bad girl, bro. No, 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 bro.
That's what it was. He was shooting games from his house. He made peas, bro. There was lions, bro. People, every time a game come out, everyone was knocking.
Man said he had youngers running for him as well.
Yeah, no, he did.
Man said he was sending man. He was sending man to HMV. Sending you to HMV
to copy the game.
That's what he'll do. He'll get the game, copy it 100 times, and but again, we couldn't afford anything else.
I can't lie. I stopped, man. Like. I've never been a gamer like that. Like I'll be lying. Like my older brother used to play PlayStation all the time. I was like casual. I was always being casual. You get me? Yeah. I was just a guy that would just do it because I enjoyed it, but I was never like addicted to it, bro. You know, like most men are addicted to the PlayStation. You get me? Like my little brother.
That's him.
Is that me?
Nah, I agree, bro.
You are online. You need to relax. 24 hours a day.
Now my little brother's always like he loves it, bro. Like he loves it so much. But me personally, I was never like, obviously, like, I'm probably going to get the PS5 and get FIFA 23 eventually, but.
He will buy a PlayStation just for FIFA.
Yeah, but to that's be honest, what I'm saying.
I am going, after this, I'm going to play FIFA 23.
You literally said it earlier.
Yeah.
When did it come out? Yesterday?
He just said earlier, he goes, oh, after the podcast, we've got, to be like on time, so we've got to play FIFA.
Well, was that with that or go to the park?
But this is what I'm saying, bro. Like, I know things for a fact, yeah. I get bored of things very quickly. Get me? That's why gaming ain't for me, because yeah, I don't do the long hour. I don't understand how man sit there. Like, for example, Foot Champs, bro. I've never understood how man do Foot Champs, bro. Like, how can you be sitting in front of your TV 12 hours, bro?
That's an addiction.
It's
got problems on that? My brother used to be addicted to that. He wouldn't leave the house.
What do you mean?
You know what you on about?
Yeah, it's Foot Champs. It's still FIFA.
He would be, it's too much, bro.
But some people.
But even waiting for them to download is long now, no?
I don't know anything.
I set it from my phone.
It takes long to download.
Anyway, what's next for you? Because time, I'm thinking about time. What's next for you? Because obviously, like, you're growing now, you're still in uni. Do people even know that?
No, they don't.
Now they know.
Well, now they do now. I don't care if people know that.
Wait, so what are you studying again? What are you studying?
Biomedical science or human bioscience, but it's basically the same shit.
So beside all the jokes, you got a smart brain.
Yeah, I'm smart, but that's kind of a pause as well. I would say I got a good brain. That's crazy, bro. The brain.
I would say you got a good head on your shoulders. Like, you're trying to get at.
Well, that's
even the worse, brain, bro.
The brain.
Is that bad? I was trying to say that man's got a backup plan. That's what I was trying to get at.
What, like, back up.
Did he say backup plan? Did he say
I said I back it up?
He said
you got a backup plan.
No, don't try.
Head on your shoulders. I don't know.
That I have in my medulla oblongata works efficiently. I'm smart. I like to think that I'm smart. You get me? Like, academically, I've always been good when I try. You feel me? So yeah, man's in uni. You know what it is, bro? It's just a thing where it's like, number one, bro, I don't film content every single day, bro. You feel me? Like, this is like, when I look at my schedule, this is still classes as a part-time thing. Even though, like, I could say the full time now.
Is this the plan, though, for you?
Yeah, 100%. This is what I want to do for the rest of my life. Nice. Bro, for the foreseeable future, you get what I'm trying to say? And it's paid off nicely, man. I can't lie, it's paying off very nicely, man. So, yeah, I appreciate everyone that supported me on my journey so far, man. I appreciate you lot for having me today as well, man.
And where can they find you? On all the different platforms? The same name?
Yeah, BillyTheGoat UK, man. Everywhere. TikTok, Twitch. Soon, I'm going to start streaming on Twitch and YouTube very soon. So subscribe. Fucking Twitter, TikTok, Instagram, Twitter. Did I say Twitter twice?
Yeah.
Twitter. And Twitter. Yeah.
You got OnlyFans yet?
Snapchat. BillyTheGoat UK. Snapchat.
And N1 Podcast.
OnlyFans? Patreon?
OnlyFans.
Patreon?
What is going on?
You know it.
Money's money, bro.
I've got fans though, but I don't know if they subscribe to the OnlyFans, I'll be honest with you.
Bro, OnlyFans ain't all about the sex, bro.
Bro, if I'm gonna do the OnlyFans thing, there's only one reason I'm doing it, bro. Let's be honest, man. You get me,
for those listening, that wasn't a clap. just so you know.
So I just fell off the table, man.
Just so you know.
But yeah, like you said before, M1 podcast, you get me. Subscribe. Everywhere, especially on TikTok. Subscribe to the YouTube as well. Gets to 10K by the end of the year.
Sick.
Bigger guest, and obviously my new show on GRM Daily is out now as well, Unprovoked. With Billy the Goat, yeah, man. Sick, get me, man. We're dead there, man.
Sick, thanks for coming on, man. And for all you are listening, as always, like, 80% of you listen subscribe. And you don't subscribe, man.
Hit the notification bell. I told you that it was free before, but I ain't telling you anymore. When you have to pay for it, that's when you are going to start doing it.
Yeah.
And that's when we're going to start making money off you.
Yeah, look, he's back to the chicken. Look, just end with that scene. Look, and look at him with his like lustful chicken eyes.
Did that sound kind of racist coming from him? I'm not kind of racist, you know?
That's where we end.
So you just bought the black guy chicken when he came to your studio? Is that all right?
Basically, see you, everyone.